Welcome back to Hand of Fate. Let's take another crack at the dealer.
I hope that is the curse that ends your quest.
The first hit in every combat inflicts triple damage. Does that include hits that I do to the enemy as well as hits that they do to me? Because this is a curse, right? I mean, from what it sounds like, as long as I get in the first hit, I should be fine.
We can hope that, as each card is unveiled, as each new concept is explored, that we learn something about ourselves, or something about you, at least.
You know, dealer, I think the only thing I've learned from playing this game is that you are a dick. Anyway, this blessing is new and also very, very good. Any kill made using an axe grants a player +3 health. As long as I actually have an axe weapon, of course, this is very good. I mean, it's like the ring that gives me +5 health for every skeleton killed, except it applies to all enemies. So this is actually really good. I'm just thinking though, how many axes do I have in my deck as far as weapons go? I mean, obviously I start with an axe, so that's nice, but I don't think I have many axes. Actually, I might not even have any in my weapons. Ooh, 20% discount. Steam sale! Oh wait, this isn't Binding of Isaac?
It has been a long time since I have seen the serpent, Mark.
Okay, let's try this again, except hopefully this time there's actually something inside of it. Ooh.
A choice. Select your desire.
I got very lucky. Huge success was on the top, and it was very slow. To your surprise, a magic spirit bursts from the casket in a cloud of purple smoke. I'm free, the apparition declares, as the stranger flees in terror. The spirit's gaze slowly comes to rest upon you. Humbly request a favor. I don't think so. You were in the desert of the damned, and you better be damned happy that I just let you out. Give me a reward. Yeah. And what would a mortal seek from one such as I? The creature asks, amused. The spirit watches you with an evil glint in his eye. That is a good question. Greater health. Riches. Any of these would be good. Give me more health. As you wish, O Great One, the spirit says, and he waves his hand, and as he waves his hand, you feel stronger. That's it? +10? With all that extra health, you surely won't require any more healing, the spirit says, waving his hand to curse you. He then vanishes. Really? Player cannot be healed.
Your ingenuity. I look forward to seeing how you approach this particular challenge.
Okay, that was not worth it. I am never letting the spirit out again. That spirit can go fuck himself. Can't be healed, okay. How I need to handle that is that I need to remove that curse right away or I'm dead. Let's see how much it costs. Yeah, I need to get rid of that curse. That is insane. No, the dog! Please be cheap. Oh, it's very cheap. 16. In fact, you know what? Can I sell something? I'm actually only 1 gold away from that. Have my crown of hindsight. Take it, quickly, so I can get the fuck out of here. Oh my god, the dog! Stop! Alright, we're good. Thank you, I'll take the ore. Let's fight.
The battlefield of honor. Or at least a close approximation.
Choose my foe. Well, the Two of Skulls is obviously extremely easy. The Three of Mages is annoying. Again, I don't know if there's a punishment or a bonus for fighting hard enemies versus weak ones, but let's go with the strongest. Because YOLO. Okay, I don't think I want to fight the golems and the mages. Actually, you know what? I think I do. It's fine. Come on, bring it on. I ain't scared. Oh my god, this is a tiny ring! What the fuck? I didn't realize the ring would be so small. Alright, it's fine. I can make this work. Okay, we're good. Oof. I better get a good reward for doing that. Three mages and two lava golems in a circle with a radius of like 4 feet. You survived that round, now do it again. Okay, I don't want to have to fight the plague. I don't want the plague being left behind after I kill the enemies, so let's go with the skulls. Yeah, this should be fine. It's gonna be very, very long.
Ah!
No damage. Also, how come I'm not getting healed? If I'm not mistaken, don't I have the blessing that gives me plus 3 health for every enemy killed with an axe? I need to check that out in a second. Anyway, I have all my gold riding on this one. A random voice yells, "Don't let me down." The final arena. Bring it on. No problem. These guys are so easy. Parade through the town, allowed to continue upon your adventure. 4 gold game cards.
I'm sure you are grateful for that.
There we go. And oh, wait a minute. Did I actually get healed? I wasn't quite paying attention, but I think I had something like 40 hit points, and now I have 66. Maybe it only applies after combat? Let's check. I don't know if it says. Wait. Surprise attack. That's not the one. Was it a ring? What was it? Wait, I'm so confused. Where did that thing go? What even was it? I thought it was a blessing, but I don't see it. Oh, wait, I'm not allowed to receive blessings, right? So they still show up. Like, it still looks as if you're getting them, but you simply don't get them, right? I think that's what happened. But then how did I gain health? I don't know, whatever.
All sorts of terrible things live in caves. Are you sure?
Last enemy alive can no longer be stunned or interrupted, that's fine.
I say that I created this game. Many of the things I've told you are true, but not that. I do not know who created it. I merely perfected it.
Mercenary contract. Ooh. This early, that is totally worth it. Ring of Peace is terrible for this. This is new. During combat, press right bumper to knock back and stun all enemies with a crash of lightning. Doesn't sound bad, but I want to go for mercenary contract because I could be very, very rich from this. Oh, yes.
What will you do with that?
Become rich? And this is pretty good, too. Because typically if you fight undead, there's a lot of them, which means a lot of cheap, easy kills, which means a lot of health. It's not bad. I'm gonna grab it.
I never liked the undead myself. Dispatch them to their rightful place.
Let's see if we can find some trouble, get some use out of this mercenary contract.
Cannot stay away, eh?
Do I want to bid some blood? I'm actually doing pretty good on blood, so... sure. 60 health? Ow. You gotta pay even if you lose the bid, alright. Don't lose. Don't lose. Don't lose. 1 in 4. Oh, fuck! It was the top card, I think. Or is the it was either the bottom or the top. I lost track of it. Yeah. Oh well. Well, there goes 60 health for absolutely no gain whatsoever. Wait, what? I totally just was mashing the key to go to the shop. Why am I fighting enemies? Ooh, that was close. This guy's very angry. Oh, that's the curse, isn't it? The last enemy standing can't be stunned or interrupted? Yeah, it is. And no, I did not forget to use Mercenary Contract. It's because I don't want to use it on too few enemies. I guess they're gonna, like, steal from a merchant or something? Man, I should get a discount for that. Like, I just killed a bunch of brutes outside of this person's, office, if you want to call it that. The mobile on wheels office. Yeah, I'm not worried about the money, because I'm gonna make a bunch of money from this. So I'm just gonna buy a bunch of food so I can go back and forth and regen. Okay, that should be fine. Pray to the gods. I've been through this before. I know what to do. I don't know. Oh! Stumbled upon a long-lost tomb, with treasure still inside. A weapon, yes! I could really, really use a weapon. Please don't be the Blood Crescent. Excellent. One of the best.
Are you sure that's the right approach?
And I don't have a food-related curse for that, do I? No, I'm good. Because there is a curse where you lose one food if you use your weapon's special ability. But, nope, I'm good. No! I ain't playing.
Nothing more pleasing than the smell of salt water and the rush of wind, is there?
The difficulty of picking a successful chance card is increased? Ugh. It's already hard enough. Jeez.
Games aren't designed. Not in the way you think. They grow as we work on them. They evolve around the players who flow through. The things they love and hate become part of our firmament. So who is the true creator?
Don't want any of those. I don't suppose you have cheap food? No, pretty normal price. Actually, I'm not... well, I'll buy a little bit. Yeah, so I really want somebody to remove this curse.
If it's portents and warnings you want, you need merely have asked.
Okay, so this is the one where I went here before with no money. And after taking a horrible chance and almost falling to my death, I found out I didn't have enough money and had to turn back. This time I actually have money. However, I do have to pass a chance card thing, and my chance of actually passing that is reduced, but... eh, I'll take it. Let's go. I did not track that, by the way. I just chose a random card. Alright, we're good. Let's pay 5 gold to learn what the gods have planned for you. The Oracle's lithe form writhes silently in the darkness for some time, then whispers to the attendant. Hmm? These cards will be put back on top. So I get to choose which one I want to be on top? Okay, interesting. Lizard Eater gets me food for every lizard killed. I don't remember that does. Don't remember what that does. I think Treasure Picker's probably the best one. That or Lizard Eater, I want to say. I think Treasure Picker gives me more chances, like more options when I'm presented with a weapon or something, or some piece of equipment. And this one gives me one food for every lizard killed. Let's go with Treasure Picker. The attendant continues to relate what the Oracle has revealed. Oh, more? There's more. Oh, these are the curses, so what curse do I want to... what curse do I want to get next? Time distortion's not bad. That just makes everything faster. It's not... It is a curse, but... really all it does is just reduce your reaction time. It's not terrible. I like the image for money bags. It's like somebody's ripped off foot, just chained to a bag of gold. Yeah, I'm gonna go time distortion.
Soldiers lacking in all responsibility. No wonder the capital is under siege from all directions.
I'm sorry, I have no helmets. Sure. Here's 20 gold.
The gods look upon you favorably.
Now, that's not a blessing, right? Or is it? That might count as a blessing, which might mean that because I can't receive blessings, it's completely wasted. It's not here, so... yeah, I think it is. So I should avoid the loan in the future. Ooh, perfect. Not so perfect. Lava Golem. Ooh. Lava Golems take a lot of hits. That means a lot of money for the mercenary contract. Let's do it. I'm gonna get so much damn gold out of this thing. Because I think it's done, I think the gold that you get is done on a per hit basis. Yeah, let's do it. Wait, do they take... oh no, do they take away that? They even take away the artifact, son of a bitch. Alright, so I can't do it. Let's see, what's around here? Get out of here, I need room to fight. Try to dodge behind him. Got stuck. Four gain cards for that. Oh, this lizard dome is amazing. Every successful combat grants a player some gold. I really am gonna be rich.
If you gain health, then I work harder to take it.
Oh my god, 40 gold.
I'm sure you are grateful for that. Caves and caverns. One cannot hope to find adventure without a little delving now.
I didn't actually mean to get rid of that. That was a new curse. Wait. But that's not the curse I chose to put on top. Maybe, oh, I guess it doesn't work the way I thought it did. Does it go from left to right, from right to left? I don't know, I'm confused. Anyway, player takes extra damage from ranged attacks. Doesn't specify how much extra damage, but that doesn't sound too bad. Food, please. Should be able to remove some curses here. Please don't have a dog, please don't have a dog, please don't have a dog, please don't have a dog. Ah. Alright, which one did I want to get rid of? This one. The difficulty of picking a successful chance card is increased. Get out of here. It's so cheap to remove, I might as well just get rid of it. Yeah. Okay. Ooh, please be two golems, actually. Two? Two? Ah, damn it. Let's take them on. I wanted two because I want to use my mercenary contract. Pain card? Yep. Just, as long as it's not a max health, I'm good. What?
Ouch.
Oh, no, 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 that's, okay. I thought that was remove. I thought that was set my max health down 50%. No, it's just my current health. Okay, that's not too bad. I mean, it's pretty bad, but not horrible. Anyway, let's get lots of money. Come on the bridge. All that money! I'm gonna be so rich! Seriously, I'm- okay, so I have 23 right now, that's my current gold. Let's see what it goes up to. That was close. Oh wait, did it just run out? I guess it is on a timer. Okay, that wasn't as epic as I thought. Still got a bit, still quite a bit of money though. Got about 20 to 30. They put the food all the way back there. Well, might as well go get it, I guess. Do some healing along the way. Oh, that's the exit anyway. But there's so much gold in the other direction. Nah, I'm gonna turn back. I want the gold. The gold should more than subsidize my journey in terms of the cost of food. You know, as long as I turn in my receipts for reimbursement. Time for some jacking.
You may wish to interfere here. Myself? I leave people to their own devices. Except, of course, for those who make the great journey to come here and bother me. Choose from these options.
We're good. We're buddies. Draw two equipment, select one to keep. Yeah, let's go with that. Ooh. Enormous shield. That's the one that slows down your movement speed, right? What about this?
One ring, empowered by all other rings. It is only regrettable that you have so few fingers.
Player receives plus one gold per ring, including this one, after every encounter. I'm gonna be so rich. My god. Do I make myself even richer? Yeah, reduces
protection
my movement speed.
Protection is a virtue, but more is not always better.
Yeah, I don't want that. Let's go with this.
Who originally crafted this ring, eh? And for what purpose?
I bet you I will take no damage. What do you bet? Alright. Easy does it. Easy. Straight line. Nice and slow. Okay, come on, camera. Really? I don't know what the fuck's over there. What am I jumping into? You know, I think the devilish part of this nightmare is the camera, not actually the traps. Where am I going? I don't even know where I want to go, I can't see. Fuck me. Oh fuck, I took damage. Alright, this is not the way to go. Ugh. It seems like you're meant to get lost, so it seems like the camera is actually meant to be part of the challenge, which is pretty stupid, because that's really... That's a very false challenge. That's a very annoying way to manufacture a challenge, make the camera really shitty. Oh, come on. Plus 5 gold for my rings. It's okay, I'll make the health back just by traveling back to the ferry boat. Get some food. Any other curses I want to remove? Last man standing. It's not a horrible curse, but I wouldn't mind getting rid of it. Again, this doesn't specify if it's enemies, you know, if this counts for me doing damage to other enemies as well as them doing damage to me. But just in case it doesn't mean that, and what it actually means is if enemies attack me, like their first attack on me does triple damage. Just in case, I'm just gonna get rid of it, because money's not a problem, so whatever. Just in case. Because I can imagine a situation where I'm fighting a boss and the first thing that hits me is like some massive attack that does 15 normally, so if it does triple damage, it's like 50 or something. Well, that'd be 45, but yeah. Just in case. Let me actually sell my axe. I really do have a lot of rings.
Another curse on the table. Let us see how you deal with it.
Okay, so if I kill an enemy, I need to make sure I go away from them in case they blow up. Gotcha.
Death. We use the word so often. You run out of food and you die. You lose your health and you die. Yet, you're still here. We do not speak of the true death, the final oblivion. Only the death of the game, where your piece begins again and moves across the table. This game, like all games, touches on that true death, however, for a life must be lost, and lost for all time.
That stupid arrow thing, I saw it and I knew there's no way I'm getting by it without taking damage. What the hell are those things? Okay, this looks like fun. Not too bad. Minimal damage.
Crypt rubbing. I'm not sure the dead fighting back makes this any more dignified.
Could have been worse. Simply means they spotted me instead of drawing some pain guards or whatever it would have been otherwise. Let's get some money here. Give me that money. I don't even know what the hell just happened. What am I taking damage from? They leave little the explosions! I totally forgot about that. That's what was happening. Oh, and you do actually have to pick up the money on the ground, by the way, before you leave. That plus five that I got, that was not from what was left on the battlefield, that was from the rings thing. And maybe the gloves. So I did leave some money on the ground, but regardless, yeah, you can see how much money I can make from the mercenary's contract. It's pretty insane. Ooh. Ah. Now I know this thing is good, and these I've never even seen before.
Speed is but a small part of the equation. Accuracy, skill, timing, these count for everything.
Attack speed is increased by 10%, but cooldown time is also increased by 10%. That does not sound particularly good or bad.
Each god is different from the next, but with one certainty, they are all as capricious as the wind.
The wearer of this armor is invulnerable for 1 second in every five. That sounds finicky. Weird, it says press B to shield bash a target, stunning it, but it doesn't actually say it stuns opponents in the list of what it does. It just says reflect and counter. I'm gonna go with this. This sounds finicky, but I wanna try.
It is good to have someone to watch over you, but this watcher has a lazy eye. These are the sort of exchanges I find most promising.
The player inflicts plus 1 damage per 20 gold in their possession up to a maximum of 10. Ooh. Well, that means at the moment I am doing plus 5 damage. Nice. I really am playing a Moneybags character. Do I go for Ultra Greed? Nah, I'm rich enough.
This token will unlock more cards if you can defeat this encounter.
Defeat? What, he's not gonna ask me to go into another cave, is he? Would you like to pay to have an item crafted? Sure. You hand over the gold and make your selection from the items a blacksmith can make. Alright, so I'm gonna use up Mercenary Contract, but then after that's done, what do I want?
Gunpowder is not the sole domain of the undead.
Press right bumper to begin dropping timed bombs at the player's location every few seconds while activated. Sounds like I'm gonna blow myself up.
Dare to summon the storm, and you may harness its powers.
Yeah, this sounds a lot safer. More like an AoE. Let's go with that. Not going to equip it just yet. Let's go check out what's at the shop. Ooh. Do you think I can double my health? Let's see if I'm cursed enough. Yes. Come on, huge success! Yes!
A close call, but in your favor.
Tiny vial of liquid. Let's see if it does the same thing as before. Maximum health is doubled! 220! Ooh, this is turning out to be a very good run. Now I just need to be very careful and don't do anything stupid. So my health is very low, but my max is high, which means I need to wiggle around to heal. Oh, it's an ambush. Oh, fuck. Okay. That was unexpected. Alright, so I have the new armor and perhaps use my vortex, maybe? How slow am I? Oh, I'm not too slow. This is actually very bad. Might as well keep getting more money, I guess. Oh right, my armor's helping me.
Hoard your gold and learn nothing in the process.
Oh my god, I'm so fucking rich. Alright, so hold on. Let me take a second here. When am I invincible with the armor? It's when everything's gold, right? So there, it just disappeared. Let's see. And gold? And gone. Can I, like, really time it to actually utilize it? Or do I just have to, like, hope it saves me at the right time? It doesn't really last long enough to really use, like, strategically. But I do think it saved my ass, because I thought I was taking shit tons of damage, but I wasn't. Also, I totally forgot about my weapon's ability. Still though, I'm so rich! That means I do even more damage, that's giving me the plus 10 damage. Because of that, the blessing or whatever. Or wait. No, wait, if it's a blessing, that means I didn't even get the blessing, right? Because I can't get blessings. I don't know what the hell's happening anymore. Everything's working out. Don't worry. Whatever the hell's happened, everything's working out. And there's a fucking dog, so never mind, everything's horrible. Life is pain. Press right bumper to cause all corpses to explode. Nah, I don't need any more artifacts. Unless it's time heals, I'm not gonna go for it. Gain you a small amount of health, press left bumper to drain health from surrounding enemies. That's the one that I never really got to get a good use out of to really tell how good it is. It sounds great, but I don't know. Ten food, holy crap, okay. Let's get a bunch of food, heal my wounds.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Okay, I'm feeling this run. This is pretty good. I've got a very good weapon. I've got good armor. Really, the only thing I'm missing for me to feel 100% confident is just time heals. If I had that, and I could bring that into the final fight with... I mean, just think about that. If I had full health, 220 health, and I had time heals, which I believe has a default of 3 charges, that's basically bringing 600 health into the final boss. Like, unless you really suck, you've got that one in the bag. See, I don't have the blessing, do I? Doesn't look like it. Nope. So I don't actually do more damage because of my gold. Gotta remember that.
All sorts of terrible things live in caves. Are you sure? Do you believe the wheel turns again and returns us to the world in order to experience afresh all that has happened? I do. Yet I cling still to this semblance of life and will not go willingly through the door.
Looks like we're going for a trip.
There's a token in it for you if you win.
As you are walking one day, a large shadow passes over you. Looking up, you see a giant eagle swooping down towards you. Let's see what it does. The bird picks you up and carries you to faraway lands. Adventure! After flying for a while, you see a monastery high up in the mountains. From your vantage point in the eagle's strong grip, you can just make out a rough, overgrown trail leading up to it. The wind whips furiously past you as the eagle continues to climb higher. Let's go with the flow. Wait until it gets tired. Eventually, after many hours, the eagle drops you into a small lake in a faraway land. Cool.
Little pleases me more than watching your attempt to wriggle away from bad luck.
Okay, I'm dead. In combat, the player's movement speed is reduced by how much gold they possess. Dude, I've got like 200 pounds of gold. I'm gonna be crawling on the ground like... Don't hurt me! I'm so dead. Like, I'm carrying an entire mobile home chained to my ankle of gold. I'm gonna pay a call to the priest and hope I don't encounter combat along the way.
It takes a very special person to walk through this door. You need to have lived a life that provides enough meat for our deck. Yet, you also need to have enough will to walk through the door. Enough power left to persist.
Oh god, how slow am I gonna be? Very slow. Very, very slow. However, my armor does make me invulnerable. So, where am I going? Whatever. Where am I going? I really don't know, I can't see. I guess that's the point.
Win this and claim my token.
Wager 20 gold? Sure. Means nothing to me. It wasn't the top, it's either this one or this one. Oh wait, neither? What? I read that wrong. Oh well. Oh, right, I visited the altar. So, health pain.
I will curse you, and I will make you suffer.
10 health per curse. I have 6 curses, 60 health. Ow. Alright, let's get rid of that damn money bags thing. Could even get rid of time distortion. It is very cheap to get rid of it. Would give me more time to react. Let's get rid of Dealer's Revenge too, because that kind of messed me up. And yeah, time distortion is so cheap to get rid of, let's just dump it. Let's heal my wounds a little bit. Come on.
Dreams, myth, and mystery. Oh, and traps, of course.
Well, at least I can move faster. Oh, this is the easy one. Yeah, I did this one before.
Voyage across the ocean, or merely a trip down the river.
I'm gonna play this one very, very slow. Just keep exploring. Sure. This may have been a mistake. On bended knee, you beseech the gods to aid you in your quest. A deafening clap of thunder answers your prayer. You feel the power and wrath of the gods fill you. One pain card, that's it? Whatever. This one's new.
Not a good day to be in Stiegel. So few are.
You arrive at the town of Stiegel on market day. Some people have been known to double their wealth on a good day at the markets. You don't say! Do you want to make me even richer? Attempt to steal some food from the markets. No thanks. The market vendors are buying food today. You may offer some food, but the amount of gold you will receive for it is not guaranteed. Whatever. Half my food. You place half your food in a sack brought by one of the vendors and stand back to await the end of the day's trading. A man approaches you with a chest containing the gold paid for your food. Okay.
A choice. Select your desire.
Oh yeah, we're rich. You open the chest to discover enough gold to double your current amount. Oh, this is the run, baby. Bring it on. I don't even care. Just got rid of a bunch of my curses. Yep, so if I defeat one more, some local villagers, or if I defeat one more, I'll be able to finally get rid of them from my deck. Also, food! I'm pretty sure I could buy the entire store. But I wouldn't want to because there's a fucking dog. Nah, that's a terrible price. Let's see. While all dragon relics are equipped, receive plus 50% max health and full healing after every combat. Full healing after every combat! Oh, I don't have all the dragon relics, though. I don't even know what they are. I don't really particularly need any of these things. Yeah, none of them really matter. Man, this episode is gonna be hellaciously long. Let's get some food.
There are only scraps left.
Wait, is that... There are only scraps left. Does that mean if I revisit a shop, there's not that much? Left behind? Is that what you're saying? No, it's fine. 5 food. It's a good deal. In fact, I could even get rid of excommunication. I could even get rid of Dealer's Curse. Yeah, let's get rid of Dealer's Curse. I'm tired of these curses. But then again, I'm so near the end, right? At least, well, I don't actually know how far I am from the end, but I'm a pretty good ways in, which means the longer you wait, the less good of a deal it is to actually do this. It's honestly, it'd probably just be cheaper to get rid of the curses as I go, rather than getting rid of the curse that gives me the curses in the first place. Yeah, let's get rid of these, but I'm gonna leave this one. This one's fine. So now I can actually get blessings. Ooh, this one's good. Guardian Angel. I think that's the best blessing. After your first chance card pick, you may return the card and draw again after shuffling. Yes, please.
Useful.
Will of the Gods, another one that gives me more money. No, I'm good. Let's go ahead and preemptively sell my medium armor, I guess. Just get it out of here. Still need to use my last mercenary contract.
Sail away and see what you will find.
It's the end.
The deeper you go, the harder things become.
Whenever the player loses a curse, they also lose one random item. Well, that's completely irrelevant at this point. There's the shop.
Even though your victory will end me, I cannot hold it against you. Life cannot help but fight for life.
I'm gonna pray to God they have time heals. If they have time heals, I win. Like, I don't even need to play the game, I'm just gonna shut down my computer, I win. If they don't, then I'm not sure. I'm in a very good position, but I'm just, without time heals, I'm scared. Please have time heals. Ah, they don't. Okay. Take a look. That's irrelevant. That's irrelevant. Rat cleaver. Hits against Ratman inflict double damage. It's good. But my current weapon does 5 more base damage. It does 35 instead of 30.
It's often hard to determine the provenance of an artifact, but this cleaver was clearly forged after the first invasion.
The average damage of this thing is actually, I think it would be worth it. It does 5 less damage on general enemies, but it does double damage against rats, and I now have to fight quite a few rats, including a few rat bosses. And it has a force explosion just like the lightning thing, which seems comparable. Stuns enemies. That's pretty much what the lightning does anyway, kind of stuns them, does some damage. It might be better, honestly, it might be. And this is very good. Can just instantly kill regular skeletons and stuns other targets. So I definitely want this. There's no downsides to it whatsoever, it's just very good and very cheap. I think the Rat Cleaver's better than Thunderstrike. Yeah, I'm gonna go with it.
You think that will help you?
Alright. I'm at full health. Nothing else to buy. Yeah, that's it. There's one more thing I need to change. I need to switch out my mercenary contract. For Eye of the Storm. During combat, press right bumper to summon a swirling vortex centered on the adventurer. So I'm probably going to be using that a lot. It sounds like some sort of AoE type thing. Yeah. Okay. Alright. I'm going to fight him in just a second. Because before this, I really have to go to the bathroom. Okay. It's time to do this, and I think this is going to be the one. So just to go through everything in my mind. Left bumper for my weapon's AoE stun attack. Right bumper for my artifact, of which I have 8 uses, I believe, the AoE attack. And then I should try to shield bash everything because my shield can not only stun opponents, but it can actually instantly kill regular skeletons. Okay. I think I'm good. Let's go.
Again, you tilt at the windmill. You will not gain your victory this time.
Here we go.
Our final confrontation begins.
Bring it on.
I will not fall as easily as the other opponents you have faced.
Destroy this damn thing. There we go. Ooh. Oh, and I was invulnerable! I keep being invulnerable. Actually, am I, like, always invulnerable? Like, unless I'm getting really lucky, I'm never taking any damage. I keep getting hit.
Ah!
Yeah, what the hell? Is it bugged? Because I'm not taking damage. I don't know if I'm just getting really lucky or what. I didn't take damage there either. Didn't take damage there either. Come on. He's angry. Hey, you designed the game. You made me invulnerable. That's your problem. Okay, there I took damage. Alright, I know I need to take out the main guy, because he makes everybody like respawn and stuff. Let me get this thing first, though. There we go. You just destroy these little whelps just by doing this. Goodbye. Wait, somehow I got healed. I don't even know how I got healed. Do I have a thing that like gives me health when I kill skeletons or something? I don't remember. Alright, got him. Take out the whelps. Goodbye. Oh wait, just got resurrected. God damn it. Alright, you're dead. Or not. Now you're dead. haven't even had to use Eye of the Storm yet. But now I think I will. Let's see what happens. I don't know what's happening. Is this good? There's certainly a storm. What just happened? Oh, finally got an attack off on me. Ow! Let me move! Alright, is the caster down? Caster's down. Let's go for this guy. Remember, this weapon does a massive amount of damage against him. Rat cleaver. You gonna do the thing? Yeah, yeah, I know your tricks. Wanna do it again? Nope. Oh, he mad. Mm-hmm.
Fate has dealt us both an interesting hand. Let us see how it all ends. You have come this far, but you must go no further. I will not leave the game in the hands of one as coarse as you.
I can't really see anything, because, oh my god, there's a lot of shit. Damn it! I keep trying to use my AoE at the wrong time. Oh shit! I'm trying to go for the totem and stuff. And the caster. See what this does. I don't know what this does. Like, is it doing AoE damage? I can't really tell. I'm just going to assume it is. Damn thing, there we go. But they just like instantly died. Ooh. Thank you.
I will not go. It cannot end like this.
Get in the portal.
One more for the game.
And that, I believe, is the end. Are these the credits, or do I have to press continue? Because if these are the credits, then they're doing a very bad job at showing me who made this game, because there's nothing here. Let's give it a second. Okay, I guess I'll continue. That was weird. I feel like there's supposed to be something there. So, this is a kind of an awkward situation now. Hi, person who I banished to another realm. So I guess that's it. I feel like I missed something. The end of the game was a black screen, and then he doesn't even comment upon the fact that I banished him to another dimension. Did I miss something? Not sure. Anyway, I guess that's the end of story mode. I'm not sure if Endless Mode is any good, I've never attempted it before. And I'm just thinking about the fact that there's still a lot of story mode stuff that I have not unlocked. There's a lot of cards. I mean, heck, let's take a look at my deck.
Until now, I have shown compassion. You would be best to test me no further.
So, that was 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. So there's 5 equipment cards that I have not used before. And, oh man, look at these. A bunch that I have not beaten before. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, there's a bunch. There's a bunch. And then we have a bunch of new ones as well. So there's quite a bit that has not been done. And I'm not sure whether those are things that I could be unlocked in Endless Mode, or what. I feel like it's probably not. I think the unlocking stuff is only for story. But, I'm not sure. I'll have to do some research. So, I'll do some research on the Endless Mode to see whether I want to play it. But I suspect I won't. Or if I do, maybe it'll be on a stream or something like that. Because I feel like I had a lot of fun doing the story mode. And if I go to Endless Mode, I might start to get bored of it. And I don't want to keep playing the game until I get bored of it. I want it to end on a really strong note. Which it did with the story mode. Even though it ended awkwardly, it was very fun all the way up until the very last encounter. And I kind of want to keep it that way. So, not sure whether I'll continue with anything else, but for now I think I'll call this most likely the end of the series. So just some quick thoughts. I freaking love this game. It's very unique. I've never played anything like it. And it's just an incredible amount of fun. It's so easy to just jump into it and just play a game. Like, it's something that I always really looked forward to, and it's just so much fun. It's like I said at the beginning, it's a wonderful mixture of randomization and kind of collecting stuff, but at the same time, skill plays a huge part. So, there's always something to look forward to, because there's always some encounter or token to unlock, or some new item to check out. So there's always something new. And there's a lot of randomization, so stuff is always different every time. You know, different layouts, different cards. Which always changes things up, but at the same time there's a huge amount of skill, because if you mess up at combat, you're gonna die. If you're really good at combat, then you're going to live. And you can make the most of a bad situation if you have crap equipment. If you play really, really well, you can still make it. And if you got really lucky and you have great equipment, then if you play poorly, you can kind of still make it. So it's this wonderful blend of just collecting stuff and unlocking stuff, and there's always something to look forward to, and there's a lot of player skill, but there's also a lot of randomization, so it's always fresh. It's just, frankly, it is a great idea for a game, and it is executed wonderfully. There's very little to complain about. I guess... What even is there to complain about? Well, okay, there's the fucking dog. I'm gonna complain about the fucking dog. There needs to be a patch that gives you an option to turn off the fucking dog. And the option is literally called fucking dog, and you uncheck fucking dog, and then the fucking dog stops fucking barking. That'd be my major complaint. That's my biggest. That freaking dog. But aside from that, the camera can occasionally be annoying, especially during those trap sections, where you can't move the camera and you just can't see where you're going. Which almost seems to be intentional. It seems like they don't want you to see where you're going, but it's really absurd. I don't think that's an okay way to make challenge, to make it so the camera's terrible. That's a very annoying way to do challenge, so camera could be better. What else? There really isn't much. I mean, almost everything is just great. I guess, like, the transitions into the stores and stuff, into the shops, could be a bit faster. Sometimes I have to mash the key to make stuff happen faster. That's really it. It really is a great game. A great idea, well executed, and I'm really hoping there's expansions or sequels or something like that. Any other game made in the same vein would be incredibly fun. I really hope to see more of it. Alright, so I guess I'll end it there. So everybody who's joined me on my various adventures through the various bosses of this game, I just want to say I hope you enjoyed, and thank you for watching.